Hi, I'm your United States Senator Chuck Grassley, and welcome to once again the weekly Ask Chuck webcast. Appreciate very much questions that have been emailed in, and I'll go immediately to those questions. By the way, I answer two or three questions this way. Those of you who emailed in other questions or tweet or Facebook, we will respond to those with a written message. John from Des Moines emails, how do we stop the Fed from operating in secrecy and without public scrutiny? For a long period of time, I felt that the Federal Reserve System has been too secret, and so I've been an advocate for the Government Accountability Office, which is an arm of Congress and does a lot of auditing throughout the executive branch of government, to also have access to the records of the Federal Reserve System. So I would open up the Federal Reserve Board by the regular Government Accountability Office audit, which I assume would be an annual audit. And I voted this way when Senator DeMint had an amendment up on the federal bank regulatory bill that's now on the floor of the Senate. That particular amendment lost, even though I voted for it. But there was another amendment that goes part way, and for a short period of time, doing what I said. I also voted for the Sanders amendment. That amendment would do this just for the period of time of what we call the bailout money. At least we're getting the Government Accountability Office into the business of the Fed to some extent through the Sanders Amendment, but the only way to do it long term and fully is to have an annual audit according to what Senator DeMint's amendment does, and I'm a co-sponsor of that amendment, and also an amendment that even though it failed, I think eventually will gain footing. For instance, I define footing by the fact that such a provision to make it long-term has passed the House of Representatives already under the leadership of Congressman Ron Paul. Go to the second question. Jane from Clinton emails this to me. How can we stop those that would offer amnesty to illegal immigrants in the immigration reform debate? Well, first of all, I think with 10% unemployment in this country, it's going to be very difficult for the majority party to bring up an immigration bill. And they can't bring up an immigration bill without amnesty in it. So I think at least through the rest of this year, we will not have to deal with the amnesty issue. Now, I would be in favor of doing a immigration reform bill without amnesty, but I cannot vote for amnesty because I believe if you reward illegality, you get more of it. And I think we've proven that between 1986, when amnesty was granted to 3 million people then illegally in the country. Then you go to a position now, when I say you reward illegality, you get more of it. That number now, instead of being 3 million, is 12 million people. So there's a lot about immigration reform that I can vote for, but amnesty, a bill with amnesty in it, is not one of those. For instance, I can vote for finishing the fence, more border patrol, e-verify through the Social Security system that people are legally in the country, and enhance penalties for businesses that hire people that have come here illegally, and do what we can to when we catch people crossing the border, not to give them access to our court system, but to deport them immediately. Things of that nature I could vote for, but not amnesty. So I thank John and Jane for your questions coming in today. I usually end my webcast by telling you what's coming up for this week and the rest of the week, and I think just a lot of amendments dealing with banking reform. You know, it's the Wall Street versus Main Street sort of thing. And I'm in falling in the camp of putting some curbs on Wall Street so the bubble that was created earlier this decade that burst and brought about the recession won't happen again. I think we'll finish up that bill this week. So I thank you very much for participating and look forward to your participation next week. And then after next week, we'll be in recess for Memorial Day, so I won't have a webcast that week.